Siginko. He always actually corrects me, and I should be better at saying his name.
We'll just call him Siggy.
We'll just call him Siggy. Versus BreakfastGun. I actually really like BreakfastGun. I wasn't playing off you enough when we were doing those jokes. Those jokes are funny.
Yeah, I like that name.
But oh my gosh, we even have all our sound working. Should we turn the music on? Sound disabled.
Maybe we should enable the sound.
Music enabled. Should we have music enabled?
I don't know. Hopefully it's not too loud. Let us know if the music's too loud, guys.
Yeah, yeah. Somebody scream somewhere if the music is too loud.
Yeah.
And let's give IBM...
Fucking void rays. Yeah, I think maybe we should have made a choice to cast this entire thing while doing our best Conor McGregor impressions.
Okay, so control one sets the score, but it's not working. So
I don't even see the score on there.
So usually you can put the score down here.
Yeah. I feel like this is the wrong game heart for that.
Oh, did I use the wrong game heart?
I have no idea, but usually it has the option. Like usually it's 0-0.
So it'll pop up. You can. Oh, maybe I need to show hide it.
Try it.
Toggle map scores. Control shift S.
Ho, ho, there we go.
Ho ho ho, dear reader. Got him. So now IBM is up 1-0 in this best of five. So the way it works, for anybody who hasn't seen this before, is it's four best of ones. And then if it's tied 2-2, there's an ace match. And you'll see when we go to like breaks and shit that we know all the players and all of the matchups and all of the maps are picked ahead of time.
Right.
But the ace is totally like captain's discretion.
Nice. I like that element. All right. So let's take a look. So it looks like we have... Breakfast bullet. I might steal that name.
Breakfast bullet.
I like that name a lot.
Yeah.
Looks like we have a breakfast gun here going for the hatch. Looks like he went for hatch first. Does he have a gas? I missed it. Hatch gas pool.
He's got one gas.
So say he probably went hatch gas pool. And our Protoss actually opted for the one gate expand, which I like. Pretty safe on this map. Obviously the rush distance is decently long. Obviously you have to route through those ramps. That Overlord is going to come across here and see that there is an expansion, so he's going to be ready to go. With that, we have the up bot Arena 2017 down there walking around. Getting in the way. Looks like we're going to have an Adept first. Now, this is interesting here with this gap, because if you look at this...
Are you talking about that gap?
Yeah, I think he's going to put a shield battery there.
Okay.
And then on the other side, he'll probably throw down another gate.
I like the Stargates. I mean, Stargate openings.
Yeah, I believe what we're going to see here is we're going to see the Adept come across. And it may have to fight these lanes, but then we're also going to see an Oracle. We're going to see an Oracle open up.
That's pretty exciting. We'll watch for if there's like more Queens from Zerg or possibly a Spore Crawler. These Zerglings are either on, intentionally or unintentionally, on move command. So they didn't even engage with the Adept. Lost half of their forces before they even got out of the gate. But there isn't really anything at home. I guess this probe's going to try to hold strong. See if you can put a wall up, put a pylon in that area, and so denies any kind of scout.
I mean, it really didn't even need to do that, but obviously it does deny the scout.
The third
deny from seeing the Stargate.
You know, the third hatch is coming on up. And there isn't really good Overlord pretension. He's going to see if he can get an Overlord in there. Curious to me, I can't see its little, like, line, but it's probably something I was supposed to turn on somewhere.
These Adepts are going to try to harass... Looks like they're going to go for the shade, go for the main.
Sure. But there isn't really much to see in the main. Like, the exciting... where the money has gone is to this third.
Right. Actually, interesting that he denied it. I thought he would have been far enough away where he would have liked to have taken that chance. The Stargate does get scouted, obviously. The Phoenix first, so this Void Ray is going to go down.
This is like the one of every tech structure.
This is the Artosis build.
Is this a known Artosis build?
One of every unit. It's a perfect composition.
It is. I mean, it'll psych anybody out. The Robo facility, the Twilight Council.
Drop three gates. I think we're going to see a Charge-A-Lot build. That's what I figured. Probably going to see him have some Oracles for support. Interesting that he does go Phoenix first. That does deny,
That's
Overlord.
Just a clean... Well, but it didn't actually deny the Overlord. The Overlord
didn't
scout everything.
No, it didn't, but he's going to use that for some scouting potential and maybe clean up any others. If he can find any others potentially on the map here.
Mm-hmm. Well, I like these queens are pretty forward. They're putting on a lot of creep.
Yeah, good creep spread. Looks like he does find another forward. Overlord. He's going to shut that down. That will supply block Breakfast Gun here.
Oh, he's got some Overlords in production, though. Should be bad.
Yep.
Going up to the lair.
Won't be too long. He already has the spores down, so There's not going to be a lot of harassment potential.
He's got a lot of extractors, but not a lot of gas mining.
See, he's actually grabbing that warp prism, so he's going to gear up here for this drop here. I want to say probably as soon as the warp prism gets up here.
No.
He's waiting for those gates to finish. He's probably going to warp in a couple.
Does he have warp gate? Yeah, he's got warp gate.
Yep.
Yeah.
Looks like he's going to go for a drop here.
We'll follow this warp prism on its little way. Phoenix, I guess, is trying to draw, and it has successfully kind of brought
he's got the third.
These queens. Yeah, he knows about it. Because the Phoenix has been up here kind of poking, pokey poke. Evolution chamber. So he's actually going for the Temple Archives, maybe to get Storm out or just Archon support.
I think he's going for Storm.
Yeah. I don't see any Hydralisk play. I don't know what the tech path actually is for breakfast. I guess Hydralisk?
Hydralisk just got thrown down, but this Zealot run by is going to do a lot. Although that Sentry is kind of out of position, needs to get over to that ramp. He is able to deny it for a little bit here. We'll see if we can do another warp, and I'd like to see another warp in of another Sentry.
Yeah, it's actually going to lock the drones in as well.
Yeah, he does have a second one here, so a lot of drones are going to go down with this.
Yeah.
So this is a good play here by Siggy, doing a lot of damage. Actually, even going for another warp in, but he's really going to want to pull all these Zealots together here. If he can surround these queens, he's in a really good spot here. Doing another warp in as well. I'd like to see, again, another Sentry to further deny.
What is this Templar doing? Is that for Phoenix? Feedback?
No, I think he's going for some Archons.
Oh, some Archons? Okay, yep. Sure. And GG is called out. Breakfast taps out.
Just a really strong two-base push there. That charge lot build is so... It's so strong.
That was a lot of Zealots all up in his shit. And he kind of moved the majority of his stuff up into those second and third bases.
Yeah, he really wasn't ready. I mean, he had a decent queen account. I mean, had the, the two queens been in there, they maybe could have denied that that war prism.
Mm-hmm.
But a little bit brutal as far as that goes. So then that puts IBM up
2-0 against team Cisco Nexus, which is really good.